Dreamhouse Biodigesters. In this video, we are going to show you how to do maintenance servicing on a typical biodigester. Coming to do a correction for this particular biodigester. The digester was done I think it should be about 4 years ago. And the homeowner has used it for that length. And then the complaint came that whenever they flush it, they have a feeling, say they can see that the wastewater that's coming out has got some human waste in it. So we just have to open it up and see what can be done about it. Every biodigester needs a servicing. So if you control the biodigester, obviously you have to have in mind the idea of having servicing done whenever the time is up. In this case, a standard family size biodigester. This one has been done in a house, a 4-bedroom house, and the digester was done as part of the human waste management system for the house. So it came to our notice that the digester needs maintenance, it needs servicing. The homeowner rents this property out. So whenever there's a new tenant coming, they prefer to do maintenance for the new person that will come. And then the cycle will start again. So we've been asked to come and do maintenance on the digester. And we are going to open it for STL to see how it is like for a digester that has been used for some time. And if you, maybe you should know him. If you can watch it, then you look at it. I say it in your hand, car, eh? And I don't know. So a typical look inside the biodigester that has been used. Now say we are in here. I don't know. It's still clean, even though after it's been used for 4 years. So what's the problem they were talking about? Okay, I think so. No money be won back. Okay. Then we have to leave the whole thing. Okay. See you will come. I think so. You not far home.
Yeah.
Okay. Now, oh, and the fifth year, it's best spreading nicely. We just have to take the whole lid off. We have to take the whole lid off to see the inside completely. Sometimes the work can be done just by lifting only the small top slab. I think it's best to lift the whole thing up just to see the complete inside. And, hey, be careful, why? And how it looks like. And now we'll lift it for the other side. Just to see the inside. Now, you need to know me, son. Okay. This is this year, you have then. Okay. What's it? Ah, okay. Right. It wasn't necessary. Yeah. There's some of them raising. Because you could have flashed with the, you know. Why are you a slab, Nana? Home on an Indian, say, when I want 1 year, you know, why you take? No raising me, Hana. When they're just all any gentle. I see it as no, you know, you know, you know, you know, just an avisa and I bet me. Okay. Yeah, no, but when I and I said, oh, you bet me you're going to stop and go out to straight to Comedian. The idea with biodigesters is that they work in the absence of oxygen. And the problem people, or the fear most people have, is that it will smell. And they are afraid they don't want their digester to be open. Or they are afraid that if they do it near their window, it will bring scent to the room. All those fears are not necessary. It's something that is got no truth in them. And this one particularly has been open. And as you can see, even though it's not been used for, I think, a couple of weeks, the human waste in it has biodegraded. And there's virtually no scent. There's no scent actually, it's not virtually, but there's no scent here. And we just want to have a look inside. The complaint from the homeowner was that the human waste was seeping into the drainage system. That was the complaint that came. So I asked them to stop using it for a few days and then we'll come and open it and see how the inside look like. And I'm just taking this opportunity to have this video done just for you to see the inside of a typical fire digester that has been used for some years. This is how they did the vent here. The vent has been done with the outlet out all the way at the top. So we don't mind a vent like this. We don't mind a vent like this at all. This is a channel dedicated to the construction of biodegradable waste biodigesters. We do videos about how this simple on-site biodigesters work. And for homeowners who are interested in using it as an option in terms of managing their human waste in their house. It's a channel that we are trying to bring to attention of people that there's another option instead of the traditional septic system or the manholes that we have. And then you can use it as part of the treatment of the human waste in your house. If you are new to us, you can subscribe and be part of this community that we are trying to build of biodigester lovers here in Ghana. We also do step-by-step videos that shows you how to construct a biodigester. We try and break some of the myths around this new technology. And we bring to your attention the understanding that you need to have when you construct a biodigester and what you should look out for. This one is just a servicing or maintenance that is being done on the biodigester that we use for some time. So you said they lift it, and I still. But I'm saying, you Like a hand. You see, we put hand on. Mortar side. Mortar side, man. Uh-huh. And I just will be a it's me. So, Miss Obana. Go for an American. Oh, to be seen, this is a man of bend. Oh, for sometimes, that's why I always prefer the distance in the middle. If it's in the middle, it's easy. Otherwise, the pressure will be on only one side. So this one is simple. So what you do is
we just
in this case, I've seen where the problem is. I think when we did it initially, we should have given it a bend so that the feces or the human waste can come into the model. But because of how the pipe was located, and after the time the job was done, this is where the pipe came. And it's not ideal because it means that everything fell there, and then with time, all the biodegradable materials there, here, got melted. It got biodegraded with the materials and the human waste itself, and then the water. So there's virtually nothing here. So that's what it means, that when the feces lives here, it becomes very like raw. It becomes raw. It doesn't contain what it's supposed to be. The filtration doesn't happen to that extent. So what it means is you just have to give it a bend and bring it to the middle and redo the bedding materials and get it to the point where it's good. So we are going to wash inside. We are going to do some cleaning inside. Or move any bit home. Pipe nip there home. The bit tribute. Yeah, they're my way near extending. Near the bedroom fifty. What's the last time? If it's here, never buy 50 here. Are you okay? So, how do I deal, you know? And I say, oh, ha. It's always best to say, if you 50 or closer to the model, no? Now it must spread. You know, you're straight, exactly. The young is a little boy. So the inside has been washed neatly, and from my assessment, I think part of the problem is the location of the inlet pipe. Where it was located isn't ideal. It should have been located in the middle, or a bend should have been attached to it so that it can come all the way to the middle. So that's exactly what we are going to do for this correction, and we are going to extend it with another pipe and make sure that the human waste comes into the middle and then it can spread evenly. What happened was, because it was done here, all the human waste got stuck here, and in the process the pressure was only on one side, so it wasn't spread evenly. So part of the recommendation is that if you are doing the digester, make sure your inlet pipe is in the middle, and even if it's coming from the side, make sure it comes all the way to the model here, either from here or from here or from here. Always make sure it's centered around the model, then the human waste can spread evenly. This goes also to show that those who do it and they put the basket inside, that's why it does not last. That's the reason, one of the reasons why we don't put baskets in the digesters. We prefer them for the human waste to spread evenly across all the levels. So this one was washed, inside has been cleaned, and all the bedding material has been removed. We are going to relay it with a new one. We are going to do some works at the outlet as well. I'm going to show it to you right now. So we have to put the fiber net in it and tag it nicely so that it can cover all the areas. The fiber net is key because when you are coming to do the servicing, that's what you remove and then you lift it together with the remains. It has to be tagged nicely. I'm just making sure that it's covered the whole place. Then now we can put the bite together material, which is the coconut husk, coconut fiber back on it. And then we'll spread it evenly. Spread it on all the coins, all the joints. Make sure that it's covering every part of it. We'll put some bioenzyme in it just to finalize the enhanced filtration and make sure the biodegradation works well at all times.